Welcome back, investors, to Ticker Time News. I'm Adam, and today we're talking about Bitcoin. We're going to go on a journey looking at a few different charts and a few opinions from other people in the Bitcoin community. If you look at Bitcoin, it's having a hard time shaking off its recent bearish turn. In one of the most widely used charts for predicting massive future Bitcoin price gains, is showing the largest divergence since January of 2019. But according to a number of analysts, Bitcoin's holding pattern over the past few weeks or even months might be about to end. Now, let's take a look at the evidence. GLASSNODE kicked things off by describing the past week's market activity as the calm before the storm. As volatility squeezes out of the Bitcoin market, it is starting to feel like the calm before the storm. Let's start with the theoretical Wyckoff model. We can clearly see Wyckoff's four stages of the market action. From September to November, we were in the accumulation phase. From November to the end of February, we had an uptrend. And March through May, distribution took place. Then we had a sharp and quick downtrend. Now we're entering nearly 2 months of relatively flat price action. We're starting the accumulation phase again. This is a very clear signal for where Bitcoin is headed. But let's keep going and look at more evidence. Now, looking at the structure formed in the last month, it seems to fit very nicely with the Wyckoff accumulation phase. In fact, I'd say that we're about to enter the spring phase, where Bitcoin may make an even lower low, giving us the perfect chance to grow our positions. The Bitcoin stock to flow model currently suggests the price of Bitcoin should be around $84,916. But as of today, Bitcoin is trading around $31,800, almost $900. Bitcoin is about 50% off from its all-time high of $64,899 reached in April of this year. Now, PLANB, who has been documenting his stock to flow model since March of 2019, tweeted that the next 6 months will make or break the stock to flow model. PLANB goes on to say about the next 6 months for Bitcoin, two things that are important. One, was $64,000 the top, and will we oscillate between $25,000 and $50,000? Or number two, was $64,000 not the top, and will the bull market resume towards stock to flow $100,000 to $288,000? My money is on number two. That's what Plan B thinks about the next 6 months. Let's keep looking at more evidence. Now, looking at the Mayer multiple, which is a simple ratio that takes the Bitcoin price and divides it by the 200-day moving average price, it appears that Bitcoin is trading low right now. So if we look at where Bitcoin is trading right now, it's trading in a bearish channel and very close to oversold. For reference, the oversold price is about $24,000, whereas overbought would be just under $200,000. Are you finding value in this video? If you are, the best thing that you can do is like this video, share this video, and subscribe to join our family of investors. We don't have the big marketing budgets of the mainstream finance media or the clout to be propped up by YouTube. So your help is greatly appreciated. Now, let's get back into it. Now, the next piece of evidence that I would like to submit is the Bitcoin long-term power law. I don't see many YouTubers using this one very often, but I really like it, as the idea is rather straightforward. There's an entire paper written just on this model. The easiest way to think about it is that Bitcoin's price evolution can be understood as moving within a corridor, which is defined by two power lanes based on time. Now, the Bitcoin price floor and Bitcoin market top both seem to follow power laws as calculated and defined. Here are the predictions from this equation. The price will reach $100,000 per Bitcoin no earlier than 2021 and no later than 2028. After 2028, the price will never drop below $100,000. The price will reach $1 million per Bitcoin no earlier than 2028 and no later than 2037. After 2037, the price of Bitcoin will never drop below $1 million per coin. I find it interesting that the green line, linear regression fit, is about $24,000 right now versus the $106,000 for the top and $8,000 for the bottom. Purely from a price perspective and totally ignoring adoption, politics, and halvings, and several other factors, this is a rather conservative view. The next piece of evidence I'd like to submit is the Bitcoin beam indicator. Roughly speaking, beam divides the price of Bitcoin at any given moment to a moving average of past prices. Also, a beam value near zero or below indicates that Bitcoin or another asset is underpriced or oversold and means that buying might be a good idea. A value near one or above means the asset is overpriced or overbought and selling is recommended. The current beam value is 0.37, so it's leaning towards the lower end of the buy zone. For reference, in early May, the beam was just over 0.7, so it was starting to get a bit hot. The beam right now isn't screaming buy or sell. It's really only tilting in the direction of undervaluation. It's not a bad time either if you're looking to add to your position. Every Bitcoin price chart I've shared with you indicates that it's not a concrete buy or sell. Instead, it's in a middle ground leaning towards buy. It's far from all-time highs, but way up from its 52-week low. The market seems to be level-headed and sane, at least regarding price. Now, roughly speaking, the floor seems to be between 25,000 and 28,000. Seeing Bitcoin drop to those levels in 2021 would not surprise me. Bitcoin has already hit 28,000 three times this year so far, twice in January and once in June. But I would be surprised to see anything below $25,000. Now, on the upper end, I've got two numbers in mind. The first is right around $85,000. This would be about $20,000 above the existing all-time high. The price charts start to hit this number in Q3 or Q4 of 2021, assuming things go well. The second upper end number is $125,000, or about twice the all-time high. If we look at the long-term chart of Bitcoin, there have always been very clear periods of accumulation, uptrend, distribution, and downtrend. And we will see these phases again and again. On the 5th of July, we saw a 60,000 Bitcoin purchase take place. We also have seen increased outflows from exchanges, which is a bullish sign as it means people are moving Bitcoin into cold storage in order to hodl. The last few months have laid out a generally negative narrative of Bitcoin, but that is beginning to change. PayPal just announced that it would increase purchase limits of crypto up to $100,000 per customer. Also, in the next few months, we should see the hash rate pick up as Chinese miners set up their shop elsewhere. I believe right now is the time to accumulate Bitcoin. Start a position, grow a position, just don't get left behind. Bitcoin is fairly priced, and you can dollar cost average every time the RSI starts to hit the bottom. Patience is key, because you will be rewarded in 2021 or early 2022. Now, what do you think about Bitcoin's price and where its price might be headed? Let me know in the comments. And if you found value in this video, then make sure to smash that like button, share this video, and click subscribe to join our family of investors. And as always, if you've watched till the end, you, my friend, are totally awesome. Thank you so very much for watching, and I will see you in the next video.